So I'll just tell you the background, how we got started. It all started in 2004 or 2005, जो अर्थक्वेक हुआ था पाकिस्तान में. एंड व्हेन दैट हैपेंड आई केम बैक, आई सॉ एंड आई टॉक टू फरजाना दैट यू नो वी आर डॉक्टर्स, वी नीड टू डू समथिंग. सो वी वेंट, शी सेड डू समथिंग, लेट्स डू. सो आई वेंट टू पाकिस्तान विद इन अ वीक विद रिलीफ इंटरनेशनल एंड वर्कड ओवर देयर. I, the disaster I saw, the deaths, especially a young boy of 10 years old died in my hands, and that kind of changed everything for me. I came back and I told Farzana that we need to continue to do something. So she left within a week and she worked over there for 10 days. And then we worked with Relief International. We made houses, earthquake, we made did some medical camps and all that. But we thought we need to do something better. This is just, you know, patchwork, nothing sustainable. So काम करते रहे. Then 2020, 2009, we formed Shine Humanity. We registered it as an NGO, 501c3. But still we were chasing disasters. You know, Haiti earthquake happened. We went over there, set up a camp hospital, did surgeries, 15,000 to 20,000 patients. Pakistan floods happened, then went to Peru, worked over there in Ayacucho, in a mountainous region over there. Recently, we did some more in Bangladesh. We went in the Rohingya camps, and but we sat together, the directors, and we said we need to do something which is sustainable, which will have an impact, and which could will make a meaningful difference. So we said, okay, no more disasters. We'll do it for fun. That is, we like it, we enjoy it, but we need to start something which will help the common man. So we said, okay, the best way to do is to do something in the rural areas, primary and preventive healthcare programs. I know there are big oncology centers and dialysis centers. So he said, to treat one patient for a cancer patient, you spend thousands of rupees or lakhs of rupees, and you save their life for a few months. How can we have the biggest impact for the dollar that we spend? And that is to prevent a disease or to treat it early on so it doesn't become an end-stage renal failure, so they need dialysis, or have a heart attack or a stroke, or you know, prevent cancer also, because they're preventive things we can do. So we started with one clinic in Gharo near Karachi, and we started a project called Helping Baby Breathe Project, which is a neonatal resuscitation. If you save a life, if you see within 1 hour, a lot of babies die. So if you resuscitate them, or you tell them how to do basically suctioning, of anti-suctioning mucus that gets impacted, you save life. So we started a project to teach. We started making master trainers. MashaAllah, say now we have trained 2,000 plus master trainers throughout Lahore and Karachi, and some in Islamabad. It's taken a life of its own now, though. Most master trainers are training others. That one clinic in Gharo, we said we'll do it right. We, you know, we treat our patients like we treat our patients here in North America. They're poor, but that's not a concern. We'll give them the. So we started with hired doctors. We did medical records, follow-ups, gave them medicine for 3 days medicine for free. We charged them 30 rupees because that's for their dignity. And in fact, we changed the culture in that area where our clinics are, because other clinics had to come up and provide better care. MashaAllah, say now we have 6 clinics in that area. We are starting a clinic in Balochistan, inshallah, this year. We're talking to somebody in Punjab right now who's interested in starting a clinic in a gown over there. So we are open to work anywhere in Pakistan, where there is need. We do surveys. We do it right. We do it in a scientific way. We do a community survey before we start a clinic, and need assessment, and then we say, oh, these are the needs, and then we work on them. And the, one of the few biggest needs in the community service that we are seeing is hygiene, water. So we have started these reverse osmosis plants that we are putting in with our clinics or in the areas. So you give them good quality water. Water, as you know, is 80% of the infectious diseases in Pakistan are waterborne. So if you provide them clean water, you save lots of life. And also primary care, just maybe vaccinations, neonatal, pediatrics. 80% of our patients are women and children. So we have started some other programs, which Muhammad Ali and Farzana can talk about it, like diabetes, hypertension, and hyperlipidemia, which is chronic diseases. If you treat them early, you prevent a lot of lives later on. Kidney failure and smoking cessation. Also, we have started a community health program. We are hiring community health nurses to go and educate the poor people over there about women hygiene, about, in fact, nobody wants to talk about it, but we do educate them about family planning also, because that's a very big problem. Nutrition is a very big problem, how to improve that. So there are many, many things that we want to do, but we want to do it right. Our main emphasis is in rural Pakistan, and with collaboration, we can work together and improve it further. The clinics, a lot of clinics are now picked up by different families in the name of their parents or in the name of their children. Some child died and they picked up a clinic and they said, this is a memorial clinic under their name.